Hi guys, today we will learn shapes with these magnetic sticks. So here are all our magnets. So what should we make? Let's make a triangle. So for this triangle we need long sticks like that one, and then let's do green. Then next, we're gonna do blue. There we go, a triangle. And if you want, for more fun, you can make a mini triangle inside. Like that. So now let's do a rectangle. So we're gonna use the same sticks. So use the small side of the rectangle. Then the other small side of the rectangle. The sides are both red. So next we're gonna put green on the bottom. And voila, a rectangle. Next we're gonna do a square. So square always needs to have all of the sides equal. So all of the sides need to be equal. So you need 1 and 4 sticks for this. And there's a square, and as the triangle, if you want to make a square inside a square, then that will be fine, but you know, you already know that. So now let's make a circle. A circle might be hard because these are sticks, so let's try our best. So for this one, we're not going to use any big sticks, we're going to only use small sticks, so the sticks don't stand out much. So for each one, we gotta have a circle. And it might look like something else, but this is the best we can do for a circle. So this is a better version of a circle. So if you wanted to make it oval, you got so see these parts, you gotta remove some of those parts and replace them with bigger sticks for it to be oval. And do the same to the bottom, because so this is a better version of an oval. So the next shape will be a pentagon. So for the pentagon you need 5 long sticks. 5. So you also need 5 balls. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So next you make a Make 3/4 of a square. And voila. It kind of looks like a house, but it's a pentagon. Pentagons look like houses. So if you want to do a hexagon, you just put in a little space. Put one more ball. And put a longer stick. And now let's do an octagon. So we need smaller pieces. So we need 8 sides and 8 balls. And a octagon which has 8 sides. So as you were wondering, you can also make 3D shapes with it, and you can also have a lot of fun, like make a house, a 3D house. So now I'm going to show you a cube, just so you have an idea of how to make 3D shapes. So first you need 1 square, and then put that aside. Then you make another square. Then put those two aside, and take those two. Take one of the squares, put little sticks on it. And make sure to use only small sticks if you're using small sticks, because you don't have that many big sticks, and also it, you know, a cube is always the perfect side. So then after you put all the sides up, then you need to carefully put the square on top. And it may look like a mess, but after you fix it, it looks just like a cube. And for the rectangular prism, you just need to make the sides over here longer. So let me show you. Just take these sides off and leave the two squares. Take big ones. That's done, put it in the half if you can. And also after you fix it, it may look like it's falling apart, but after you fix it, it looks like a rectangular prism. Now next, you may be wondering how to make a pyramid, because, you know, it's cool. So for a pyramid, first, put this aside. You need to make a square. Okay. Then you need to make 2 triangles. Actually, let's make 1 triangle. Remove the bottom part, remove the walls. and put it right here. And you see the two sides are complete. But what about the other two sides? So you need to make you need to take two small pieces, then stick them to the small pyramid. And also, if you would like, you could make the sides bigger. But I prefer small ones.
Wow, that's looking good.
So I think that's all the shapes.
And you want to make any special shapes you want? You want to do an experiment with all the sticks?
Huh, let's make a house.
Okay.
So for a house, since you already done the pyramid, you can put that aside and make a square with small sticks. So as you see, we only made the pyramid. But if you're wondering, if you want to make a 3D diamond, you can just add four sticks on the bottom, but make sure to hold them all. So, and there you go, a diamond. And if you're not satisfied, because that's all, a chandelier. And it even moves on the ground. Isn't that cool? So now, let's make a house. So let's just put this aside. Take four pieces off this diamond. The four pieces you added just now to the pyramid. And we put that aside because we need that later. So now let's make a square. You can make it colorful, but you can make it colorful as much as you want. So since it has four sides, I'm gonna use four colors to make it colorful. So since that's done, we need to add four big sticks. Like this. Then put it back. Then put the pyramid on top of it. And it's a house. So if it's not properly fixed, you can also make it like a chandelier, like the diamond, but it's a house, so a rocket ship. So if you actually want a rocket ship, you can just make another pyramid and put it on the bottom, but it's too wobbly. So let's try to make a funny shape because, you know, let's have some creativity. So I'm just putting two small sticks over a big stick. I'm gonna put two balls. And I'm gonna take two big sticks and a ball to here. And put one stick here, but I'm not done because it has to be funny. It just is not funny. So I'm gonna put one here. I take another big stick, put it here, and if there's one more left, I can take that and put it there, and have another small stick and put it there. Actually, that's supposed to be reverse. There, that looks much better. And let's take two small sticks and this isn't even a shape, it's supposed to be funny, but goggles? It's like goggles. It looks like a goggles, not a shape. Or you can just put it on your head. This way. Which way you like, you can make other funny shapes. Use your creativity. So I'm just gonna add one more to it. I'm gonna put one here. If this doesn't work. So I'm gonna put one big stick here. And the other here. It's like a hand holder thing. You can dig with it. If it gets, although if it's too big for you, you can use small sticks. But if you use small sticks instead, it does not look good because. So I'm gonna make a big shape this time. Big shape. I'm gonna put little sticks inside, or you can do that before you build this fork. I'm gonna use all the sticks. This on the top. Flip it. I'm gonna make a secret underground entrance. I'm gonna do a pyramid. And for these two, you can put it like here. Or you can just put this ball, just like a hand holder. So let's put a shape on the ball, bottom. Maybe the big one should be here instead.
Can you turn that? Can you turn that?
Looks like a machine when you do something with it. Like if you pull this bar, it goes crazy. So you can do a lot of shapes with these sticks. And thanks for watching. And enjoy these magnetic sticks.